in winners finals.
So we're gonna switch over to the loser side. Let's check out the bracket while we're waiting here. We can see what's going on. So there is winners finals, Infiltration and K-Brad. We're not gonna run that yet. We're gonna go to losers. Chris G against 801 Strider and Hello Kitty Ricky against Snake Eyes.
Ugh.
Ooh, it is gonna be a grueling matchup, folks. Grueling matchup between two of the best footsies players in the States.
Mm-hmm.
Two of the players who have some of the best reactions, best understanding of space control. They both can take advantage of mix-ups. When it's time to mix up, you know, they both are very good at that.
Who will emerge a champion?
I'm interested to see, though, what character Ricky plays, because, you know, she's been working on a couple of characters, right? And I have to think that part of that was to deal with the Geef matchup. You know, she and Justin Wong think that that's a bad matchup for Rufus. Rufus versus Geef.
Right.
There is a little bit of dispute about that. Some people think that it's even. Some people, in fact, think that it's a win for Rufus. It's one of those that's all over the map. But for them, they think that it's a loss. So I wouldn't be surprised to see her go to somebody else. Yeah, Chun.
Yeah,
okay, cool.
Okay,
cool.
This is what we saw earlier. This is what K-Brad did, remember?
Yeah, that's right. And K-Brad's sitting right next to her, so she's going to, you know, she'll, look, she already knows how to play Chun against Geef.
Yeah, she's been doing it for years against Van Geef earlier on in Street Fighter IV's lifestyle.
Yeah.
Lifetime.
I just think that Ricky's style is a really good fit with Chun-Li. You know, she likes to play offense in this game, but when I think of Ricky Ortiz, I still think of CBS2 and just lame control. You know, lots of control. That's what I think of still. So I'm sure she can do this, but we'll see how Snake Eyes approaches it. Okay. Very important to establish that you can whip punish.
Ooh, good time.
Oh, not punish.
Yeah.
Wanted legs, I guess.
Maybe close roundhouse was
oh,
he
close
was expecting.
Roundhouse.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would make sense.
Ooh, wow. And then just goes right into SPD. I mean, after the EX screen hand, Snake Eyes goes for low short a lot.
Sure.
Because people try to jump away. So he catches a lot of people before they can get jump away. I'm pretty sure Ricky, you know, was thinking, oh, I'm just going to block this low short or low jab off the EX screen hand. Snake Eyes mixing it up, getting the SPD.
He's just trying to maintain space control. The, sort of the balance that you have to go for as Chun is that you're going for space control without being too active. Because if you're too active, you give too many buttons that Snake Eyes can whip punish, just like we saw.
Right.
You know, you want to avoid that. But at the same time, you want to have enough buttons that he doesn't just get to walk forward. So it's a little balance. Not always easy to strike.
Yeah, I just remember now. Oh, no, yeah, that's the perfect bait. And that's the perfect punish. I just remember these two played in top 8 at NCR right at the start in loser's bracket. Can't remember who won though. Nice chase down with Snake Eyes.
Okay, that Chun pick didn't work. But I do think that Ricky should stick with Chun. I think that's the right call.
So are you a believer that Zangief wins against Rufus?
I think it's pretty even. Okay. I've always thought it's pretty even.
Uh-oh, baited that out. Yep, just punishes with a throw. Not a huge punish, but you know what? At least she got the punish.
You just don't want Geef to be near you. Those whiff punishes are just excellent. Stand short, stand medium, punch.
God, I swear, every time it looks like Zangief is out of range to keep any combos going, he's always still in range. I don't understand that.
Well, if he wants to spend EX bar, he can pretty much always.
Right.
Yeah.
Wow, okay. Low fierce anti-air. I like it.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Like I said, pretty much every button that Chun-Li has can be an effective anti-air. If you just alter which ones you use, it makes it very difficult for your opponent to counter it.
So Snake Eyes is not really jumping. Oh, he did, but at a safe range, much farther away.
This is dangerous now. With Ultra 2 all stocked up, it's really going to be hard for Zangief.
Yeah, he really can't go to the air unless he wants to test Ricky's reactions. Few people do that and live the tail. It's tough to do.
Yeah, and there was. You saw the early anti-air from Ricky that time. I mean, Zangief has a great button and jump forward. Beats a lot of anti-airs. Should beat a lot of Chun-Li's anti-airs. But like I said, if you just keep altering the timing, yeah, right there. So he did it early. That time he did a later jump and beat the late anti-air. See, that's the game that you got to play.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
One more mix-up is going to seal the deal. He got
wow.
it.
Wow. Gets a stun.
Oh, is that enough? Ooh. He definitely pushed that to the limit.
Yes. Oh, got in and used the jump knees. Jumped short. Very low block stun, so caught him with a, caught her with a surprise SPD.
He's just trying to outrange those buttons. You know, his goal right now is to be either way up close, obviously. That's primary. But to do that, you have to be outside of her buttons, just like that. That's the way you get in.
Yeah, he gets the perfect whiff punish now. The setup.
Oh, the dash,
that was
it.
So beautiful. Yeah, great stuff.
Oh, what?
That was sick. If Ricky did that on purpose, that was so sick.
Yeah, that was pretty great. Ricky does need to make a comeback here, so she can't just hang out.
Well, she's got a lot of meter, so once she has the super, she can punish a lot of things. But Snake Eyes doing Lariat only when he sees Ricky walk forward. Oh my gosh. That whiff punish is from so far.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, you see that Snake Eyes trying to stand at a certain distance, because if he gets too close, then Stand Strong will link into super, Stand Fierce will link into super. Oh, he dropped the combo, but he very fortunate that Ricky just ate the jab green hand that came out.
I actually do think that Geef does better against Rufus in this version than before, thanks to EX Hand Red Focus working on against Crouching Fierce. I think that's pretty nice.
That's right.
Oh, big timing.
Yep. And I love that whenever he gets that jump fierce like that, he has the proper reaction to go for a sweep for the hard knockdown. Oh, so much damage, that white life off of the splash. I mean, it's still better because you get away.
Right, yeah.
But so far, he's been able to jump a lot, even though Ricky's had that ultra too.
Oh, yes.
That's going to take it. Oh, maybe not. Oh, man.
Needs chip. But you can't throw a fireball right now. Oh, very smart.
That was beautiful,
very smart. Yeah, you just you can't throw a fireball.
I was actually really glad that Ricky didn't go for overhead jump roundhouse. Jump back roundhouse. I was really glad because Snake Eyes called that out earlier.
Well, do what you gotta do. Snake Eyes has now gotten Ricky into the corner. Ricky trying to be active. Okay, I like that. But Snake Eyes is still doing just a great job of outranging. Yeah, just like that.
Oh, interesting. Okay, that's gonna work. And Ricky's gonna spend the ultra meter right now. Wants to get as much damage as he can.
And it does give her the life lead.
And also the distance too, which is nice.
Oh yeah, jump fierce. So now Snake Eyes has to make a comeback. But look, he's a hit away from doing it.
Mm-hmm. In fact, right now, Stand Short, EX Green Hand into Focus. Oh.
Nope, he didn't have red yet.
Oh, I was just saying that regular Focus might have done pretty decent. But he's going to save it rather for, oh, okay, big problems now. He's got to go for a Hail Mary EX Green Hand or just figure out a way to just jump right when Ricky's not expecting
it. Yeah, I think he wants to outrange dash forward EX legs.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he's coming in. He's coming in.
Oh, the Snake Eyes is going to take that round. Wow. The last thing you were expecting because he hadn't pulled it out all match.
Snake Eyes walking up. Wow.
That whip punish ability that Snake Eyes has, so good. Okay, good stuff. Good timing from Ricky. Changing up a little bit of that timing. Saw her wait just a little enough, and then low roundhouse right when Zangief walked forward. Okay, adding that standing roundhouse. Oh no!
Man, I just don't know why you would throw a fireball there.
Testing the reaction. There's always
these are these players.
Yeah.
Our players, you do that against.
Right. Safe jump setup.
Oh, Ricky's got a couple more bars to fish for that whip.
And it should do a lot of damage, too.
Oh, yeah.
It could kill. Oh, wow. Hit the stand roundhouse.
Yeah, wow. Snake Eyes can win on the next hit right here. Actually, so can Ricky. Depends on what she gets. Very tense right here, Snake Eyes on the verge of eliminating Ricky Ortiz.
And Ricky now with a life lead, I believe, just by like a pixel
right.
or two.
Oh! Here's Snake. Trying to come in.
Ooh.
Ricky, can she stay away?
Oh,
my
God! The jump fierce beat, the jump back roundhouse. Ricky, that's exactly what Ricky wanted.
Ricky wanted that interaction, expecting that her button would win.
And it didn't.
Oh.
Not a good.
And they say Jump Pierce was nerfed. That's what Capcom told us.
We're gonna need the pictures. We're gonna need the hit.